Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Walt Disney after it secured enough shareholder votes to defeat a challenge from billionaire investor Nelson Peltz. Walt Disney shares are slightly down before the bell. Also in focus, shares of Calmain Foods after its fourth quarter results beat Wall Street estimates. Calmain Foods shares jumped 8% in the pre-market. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of HSBC after its chairman Mark Tucker told the bank shareholders a spin-off of its Asian business will not happen, saying there is no appetite among the shareholder base. Investors welcomed the announcement and sent the stock climbing 1%.
Asian markets ended Wednesday trade with sharp losses following Wall Street's slide overnight. Markets from Japan, Hong Kong, Australia, and South Korea all saw declines of about 1%. Taiwan's SIAX index, meanwhile, fell 0.6% after the deadly 7.4 tremor Wednesday morning raised concerns about possible disruptions to the island's vital chip-making industry. Here at home, the PSE index deepened its losses, falling for a second straight day.
It seems that investors might still be on a wait-and-see mode, possibly being sidelined by expectations of inflation accelerating again, which would be confirmed by the March inflation report coming out this Friday. So sentiment could have also been affected by Wall Street's weak performance last night as U.S. Treasury yields continued to climb back up and investors continued to push back on expectations on rate cuts. So looking at the bigger picture, participation has largely improved year to date with the average hovering at around 5B for value turnover excluding block trades.
Some notable stock movements in the region. Shares of Taiwanese shipmaker TSMC slumped 1.3% after it said some facilities were evacuated following the quake. Meanwhile, shares of Uniqlo owner Fast Retailing slumped more than 3%. That's after it reported its first year-on-year sales decline in Japan in March. And finally, Japanese trading firm Itochu bucked the regional downswing, with its stock surging 6.3%. This is as the Warren Buffett-backed company forecasts a 10% rise in its net profit this financial year and announced a new management plan. The Philippine government exceeds its spending target in 2023. Expenditures last year hit 5.3 trillion pesos. This was higher by 107 billion than the target. The budget department justified the bigger spending on the need to fund more infrastructure projects and other capital outlays. It also attributed the government's higher operating expenses to social services-related agencies catching up on spending.